What's up, y'all? It's Demogenon. It's time for another one. So, I've got a couple stories for y'all. One of them I noticed because we are heading into the Halloween holiday. And I thought this was kind of crazy. And big shouts to the peoples on Twitter. I forgot who posted this one up, but I just saw it on Twitter. This is from the ADL, which is... I had no use to read or pay attention to them, but this did pop up. So I was like, I had to talk about this because, like, of course, everything's freaking problematic. So Halloween, when it comes to Halloween, when the goblins and ghosts and stereotypes come out, of course, we got to make something that's relatively fun and just, for kids to dress up and have a little fun, play a little dress up, whatever. You got to turn that to a problem. So what does this say? So when autumn blows in, Halloween fun close behind, and yet sometimes the opposite of fun. Parents sometimes cringe in anticipation of what their child's costume will be. Teachers may worry about the stereotype costumes in the playground taunts. College campuses near up parties and resulting in bias, conflict, and controversy. Halloween should be festive and exciting when approached thoughtfully. A holiday can not just bring candy and costumes, but creativity and learning and community and building. But also ensure Halloween and other holidays are positive and experience for all. They need to be inclusive and respectful, of course. So, I'm not going to read this whole thing. So basically it's talking about like cultural appropriation, cultural stereotypes and costumes that marginalize those who don't conform to traditional gender norms. All right. So I'm going to say this, we need to, this 10 level we're at, I need y'all down to a 2, okay? Everything is not a problem. If everything's a problem, then nothing is a problem, okay? So you're going to tell me for centuries now, people have been doing the same thing, and this is the problem, because they like to say like things like with... stereotypes and appropriation, right? So that's what they were talking about. So somebody dresses up like as a Native American or Indian, however you want to call it. Again, if we're not sharing, I mean, put it to you like this here. We are in a melting pot of a country. You can't sit there and try to segregate everybody. Something is going to spill over. Now, if you're being, I can't even see like right now, who's actually being disrespectful with this stuff now, really? Maybe if you want to go back, half a century ago, people was doing certain things. Okay, I can see it. If there are people who are being, like, actual disrespectful when it comes to any type of, like, dress up, somebody does, like, a black face or whatever, stuff like that, it's probably a less than significant amount we're talking about. Because right now, you cannot tell me that there are people who thinks that doing something sideways is okay. You can't tell me that is, right? So, I just thought it was a little crazy when I sit there and say, because by the way, let's be 100%. When it comes to, especially when you talk about, for little kids, it's really the parents who's dressing them up, right? You might have to say, the kids might say, well, I want to be this or whatever. If they're old enough, right, they'll say whatever they want. Usually it's going to be some sort of cartoon or whatever. It's popular, right? It's usually the teens and adults who'll do something, right? And usually what do those outfits usually be? It's usually a sexy version of something. I don't hear him talking about that, right? Did they even put that in here? Yeah, see, obviously you got something about blackface. Yeah, like I said, who does anything like this, right? So it's... Yeah, they don't even talk anything about like the sexy costumes, because that's basically where most of the Halloween ends up becoming anyway, right? Sexy this, sexy that. You get some dope cosplay type of deals coming on. But really, whatever. But I just thought that was interesting, meaning that we're coming up to the Halloween holiday. And I just thought it was crazy that we got to have this. This is a conversation we're having. Nothing can be fun anymore. Nothing. Nothing. Everything has to be ist and phobic and somebody's problematic and all this stuff, blah, blah, blah. But anyway, let's get into something that... Holy smokes. Now this one, who did this one come from? Big shouts to Commander Cody Talks Fandoms on Star Wars, on Twitter, sorry. It says, is Jaina Solo Rey? Now, This is from Jana Solo, Star Wars Canon Extended Wiki, right? Wikia. Since Jana Solo is a twin sister of Jason Solo and a daughter of Rey Skywalker and Kylo Ren, making her the granddaughter of Leia Organa and Han Solo. Go F yourself. Whoever wrote that, because you think this is fake because it's on Twitter? Nope. I looked for it. It's there. This is Google. I Googled this. It exists. This is actual Google. I don't know what this site is, but whoever did that, go F yourself. Don't ever disrespect my Jaina Solo ever again. Don't put Rey and Jaina Solo in the same sentence, not unless you're trying to play Rey out, because Rey is garbage compared to Jaina Solo. Garbage. Okay? So, who is Jaina Solo? Jaina Solo is a human female Jedi Master of the New Jedi Order, the Sword of the Jedi. Member of the Jedi High Council, wife of Jagged Fael, and twin sister of Jason Solo, the oldest sister of Anakin Solo. During the war, she became most romantically involved with the fellow pilot Jagged Fael. Obviously, we know that because she marries him in the end of the Abelof series. So, I'm just going to tell you like this here. Jaina Solo is my second favorite Star Wars character next to Luke, right? And I said this many times. I enjoy her story arc. Mind you, I don't have everything, but I do have like a good chunk. Like I said, I have about 30 books of the EU, right? And I love Jaina. I love the fact that she's, you know, Leia's daughter, Han's daughter, that she's a Jedi Master. You know, I tell you, one of my favorite, and I mention this all the time, and I will continue to mention this because it's one of my favorite scenes in the book. When I say scenes, that's something I read, obviously. But when Luke promotes her to master, I just love that. And I get chills thinking about it all the time because they are being overwhelmed by the Sith. Luke is cornered. Jaina has like a broken rib or something. And he calls out to her. He says, "Master Solo, I need you." You understand that? That to me is just so powerful because you see, as dope as Luke is, his niece is just as dope as he is, and it didn't take away from any of them. And that's what I liked about that. Because you could put, that's the kind of Star Wars that I wanted. Don't you fools ever put Jaina in a bloodline of Rey Palpatine ever again. Don't disrespect her. Put some respect on Jaina Solo's name. That's all I gotta say about that. But anyway, how do y'all feel about this? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you get my videos in the drop them. And remember, you can't be good at it. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.